Hello students, in the previous class we have already studied about the basics of Gauss-Seidel method. In that method, in the last equation we have already derived the equation for the calculation of voltage for PQ bus. That equation was Vi equals to 1 by Yii into Pi minus jQi divided by Vi star minus summation of k equals to 1 to n as well as k does not equals to I Yik into Vk. That was equation, equation 8. This equation we have already derived in the previous class, where I varies from 2 to n. N is where n is the maximum number of buses, and so on. So further, this equation has been further rewritten as, if we want to calculate the voltage of ith bus for iteration, let's assume t plus 1th iteration, the t plus 1th iteration, in that case this equation can be rewritten as 1 by yii. Now this equation p will be pi minus jqi divided by vi of tth iteration conjugate minus summation of k equals to 1 to up to k minus 1. This will be yik into vk for t plus 1th iteration minus when k equals to k plus 1 to n. This will be yik into vk for tth iteration. This was equation number 9. These two equations already we have derived in the previous lectures. Here you can see that for t plus 1th iteration, if we want to calculate the voltage of ith bus, that means let us assume that we want to calculate the voltage of fourth bus. So before calculating the fourth bus voltage, already we have already calculated the voltage for second and third voltage, and already we have assumed that first node voltage is as a slack bus, or we have assumed that one. So for calculating the fourth number of bus voltage, we know V1, V2 and V3. That's why this equation for the before calculating the ith bus voltage, we know this, that means up to V, already we have calculated V1, V2, V3. So that's why from k to k minus 1, this is Vk and t plus 1, and that means this is at the for the same iteration, whereas Vk, that means V5, we did not calculate it in this iteration. That's why here this V5 will be taken from the previous iteration, that is Vt, that means the tth iteration values. In this way, we will calculate the voltage of all the buses. In this equation, if we further express this equation, then for any PQ bus, we will know PI and QI, and YII is a line parameter that is already known, that is it is taken from the Y bus matrix. That's why for every iteration, this divided by this, that means this term is known parameter. That means fixed, known, not known, this is already fixed because it will not change in different iterations because this is not dependent on t value. See here. That's why if we consider pi minus jqi divided by yii, as let us assume that this is A I, and similarly the second portion, that means Y I K as well as Y I I, this is also a fixed parameter, that is fixed known things, it will not change in different iteration. So let us assume that Y I k divided by yii is assumed as, let us assume this one is b, capital B I k, where obviously from this equation here k varies from 1 to n, whereas k is not equals to I. So k varies from 1 to 2 up to n. As well as k is not equals to I, and I varies from 2 to n. So in this way, this expression can be, now this expression can be rewritten as, or this equation can be rewritten as, so in this way, V I t plus 1 iteration equals to, this term is A I, so this will be A I divided by V I in for t in tth iteration and its conjugate, that means this one, minus summation of k equals to 1 to k minus 1 I minus 1, sorry, in this equation this will be I minus 1, I minus 1, oh sorry, this will be I minus 1, and this will be from k equals to I plus 1, this will be, sorry, this will be I plus 1 to up to n, because see here, this I minus 1, why we have taken as I minus 1, because up to here k varies from 1 to n, except k will not be I, that's why up to I minus 1 the expression is like this, and after I plus 1 will not take I, because I is not valid for here in this equation. That's why k equals to I plus 1 to n, this will be equation as a this. In this way, this will be from k equals to 1 to I minus 1 into this term, that is bik, bik into v k for t plus 1th iteration minus summation of k equals to I plus 1 to n, this will be bik into vk, and in this equation, in this part, this will be from tth iteration, that is from previous iteration. Here also I varies from 2 to n. In the previous lectures, we have already written a similar way. We have written the equation, that is from k equals to 1 to k minus 1. Here also it is mistakenly we have I have mistaken, and that's why this will be k equals to 1 to I minus 1, and here k varies from I plus 1 to n. This was typo error. Now this is the equation that will be used for the calculation of voltage of ith bus in t plus 1th iteration. Now the iterative process is continued till the change in magnitude of bus voltage, that is mod of delta V of ith bus in t plus 1th iteration. This between two consecutive iteration is less than a certain tolerance for all the bus voltages. That means, let us assume that this tolerance limit is epsilon. So in this way, the mod of delta Vi in t plus 1th iteration, this value will be what? This value will be mod of Vi in t plus 1th iteration minus Vi in tth iteration. This will be less than, should be less than equals to epsilon. That means the all this process, that means the iterations, has been continued till this value is satisfied. If this value is satisfied, then we will not calculate the voltage for the next iteration, and that voltage will be considered as the final bus voltage, and according to that bus voltage we will calculate the loss as well as the power of the every buses. In if for any situation if mod of vi, that means for any in any iteration, if this value is less than or you can say that this is vi mean and mod of vi less than vi max, this should be valid or accepted for any bus. If this inequality expression is not satisfied, in that situation we will consider that bus voltage is as a minimum or maximum depending upon the which limit is violated. That means if case 1, if mod of vi is less than mod vi mean, then in that situation this voltage will be vi equals to v min. In case 2, if mod of vi is greater than mod of vi max, in that situation as well vi is considered as mod of vi max. Now the acceleration coefficients, doubles, acceleration of convergence. Sometimes the Gauss-Seidel method is not so fast, and in that situation it will take several iterations to converge the solution. That means it will take so many iterations so that the mod of voltage, this will be within the prescribed tolerance value. So in that situation, if the acceleration, if the Gauss-Seidel is not converging within the prescribed, that means the iteration, in that situation we have taken a constant alpha, that is acceleration of convergence or acceleration coefficient, and with this alpha we will speed up that Gauss-Seidel process, that means the calculation process. So in this case the accelerated value, that means vi t plus 1 for t plus 1th iteration, that means this is accelerated voltage will be what, the vi tth iteration plus alpha into this thing, that means vi t plus 1 minus vi t, that means this is what, this is delta vi t, this is delta vi. Delta vi is, that means the voltage of any bus in the t plus difference between the voltage difference between the t plus 1th iteration and the previous iteration, that is tth iteration, and this is the accelerated value of voltage. This alpha varies, is taken as a just a random value, the appropriate value of alpha depends on the whole the problem that is given in the given for the solution. In general, the alpha is recommended as alpha equals to 1.6. A wrong choice of alpha also may indeed slow down the convergence or even cause the method to diverge. That means that solution will not converge at any cost. So if for any particular problem alpha is given, then we have to consider this alpha, or that value of is given. If the alpha is not given, in that situation we will not consider this alpha, and in that case the tolerance is will be like this, and we will consider only Vi t plus 1, that will be calculated from this equation 10. Since in this steps we have calculated, that means voltage, that means this expression is only valid for PQ buses, because here we have considered P and Q as a given data, and we have calculated according to this given data we have calculated the voltage, that is here V is unknown. For PQ bus V is unknown, and since we have not taken considered the magnitude part only, that means in this voltage, magnitude of voltage as well as the angle of, that means delta I and mod of Vi, both can be calculated with this equation. So but for PV bus, obviously in this bus P and magnitude of voltage is known, but Q and delta is unknown. Unknown things. So the for PV bus we will not again calculate or again find this voltage, because this is already given. So in that case for the PV bus we have to calculate Q and delta. So for PV bus, we have to calculate Q and delta. So already in the previous lectures we have calculated or we have derived the expression for Q. In the previous lectures, see the equation number 4. In that equation, P minus jQ equals to Vi star summation of yik into vk from k equals to 1 to n. So from that equation, that is from equation number 4, we will calculate the same from equation 4 minus of that means we can say that Q equals to Qi equals to minus of imaginary part, this is imaginary part of Vi star into summation of k equals to 1 to n, and that was yik into vk. And that is taken from the equation number 4. So here the qi can be calculated by this expression, say this one. Let us assume that we know that in any systems all bus will not be only PV bus, but it may be only PQ bus. So let us assume that if a total number of bus is n, where total number of PQ bus is m minus 1, since total number of slack bus, obviously slack bus will be always 1. So the total number of PV bus will be n minus m minus 1, that means n minus m, and the n minus m number of PV buses in the system. So for PV buses the voltage is given. So the first PQ bus, for only PQ buses we will calculate the voltage VI. After calculating the voltage, that is VI, then for PV buses, we will calculate Q. So this QI can be equals to minus of imaginary part of VI star into summation of k equals to 1 to n yik into vk. But here I will varies from, not from 2 to n, because here not all the buses are PQ buses. So for calculating this QI, the I will varies only from, that means up to m plus 1 to n. Because we have, we will arrange the system like first number bus will be a slack bus, then after that all PQ buses are arranged, and then in the last form the all PV buses are arranged. So from m plus 1 to n, that means I varies from m plus 1, that means the last n minus m buses, since because last n minus m buses are PV buses, so I varies from m plus 1 to n. That means for calculating the QI in t plus 1th iteration, this is the general formula, but for calculating the Q in t plus 1th iteration, that means this will be equals to imaginary part of, this will be VI T star, that means conjugate, because for ith bus, let us assume that for m plus 1th bus, still we have not calculated the VI. So this VI, since in this case V is known, that means VIT we have considered as a previous data, that's why we have taken as VI from Tth iteration. So this will be conjugate into summation of k equals to 1 to up to I minus 1. Up to k, from k equals to 1 to up to I minus 1th iteration, because we have started the calc, this expression is represented as the bus reactive power Q from for ith bus. So from up to I k 1 to up to I minus 1th value, this will be in from the same, because already we have calculated that things, so this will be yik into vk t plus 1. This will be from from the same iteration, because prior to I value we have already calculated the voltage, and after that plus V. So this will be VI T, or just take the common. So this will be from k equals to 1, sorry, k equals to for I to n y I k into v k from tth iteration only. And here I will varies from m plus 1 to up to nth bus. So in this way, because in the second part of this equation, that means this one, for calculating the ith Q, ith bus Q, so prior to this ith bus we have calculated the previous Q, that's why in the prior to ith bus we have used the voltage of in that iteration, whereas after the ith, because we are calculating the ith bus q, so after that value we will take the voltage of this particular bus in from the previous iteration. That's why this is t. So in this way we will calculate the q, and also in the similar way we will calculate angle, that means in the t plus 1th iteration. From where, how we will calculate this angle? Because that means for calculating this angle we have to calculate vi in t plus 1th iteration, and then from this value we will take the only, we will calculate the only angle part. That means delta I t plus 1 is equals to angle of vi t plus 1, that means which is equals to angle of a I r a I t plus 1 divided by v I t star minus summation of k equals to 1 to I minus 1 and b I k into v k t plus 1th iteration minus k equals to I plus 1 2 up to n. This will be b I k into v k for only tth iteration. Here see, we have taken a I t plus 1, but in the previous previously we I have considered that AI equals to P minus, sorry, PI minus JQI divided by YII. That was fixed because in that PQ bus all P and Q are known. But here, since this is PV bus, so P is only known, but Q is not known. That's why we cannot consider this AI as a constant things in every iteration, because in every iteration the QIT plus 1 is changed. That's why here we cannot consider this as a fixed value. That's why this in this expression we have taken as AI T plus 1. That means here a I t plus 1 means what? P I minus j q I, and this is what? This is from t plus 1th iteration divided by y I I. These things are same, but here q i is changing in each and every iteration. That's why now we have considered this a I t plus 1, sorry, this is the things. So with the same help of this the voltage formula, we will consider the angle part only and calculate the whole angle of that that PV buses. And hence Q and delta can be calculated with these two equations for the PV buses. But here also we have to check the limit of this QI and as well as delta I, so that the particular calculation is viable or not, to check that limitation. Now just consider a situation that if this QI t plus 1, that means for any iteration, if this is less than QI, mean that is the fixed part. If the system if it is given that QI cannot be below that this minimum value, as well as in that situation we will consider as QI t plus 1 equals to that the same QI mean, as well as if QI t plus 1, let us assume that this is greater than QI max. In that situation as well, QI t plus 1 can be considered as QI max. But if we, since we are fixing this QI t plus 1 to minimum or maximum values, so after fixing these QI and Q mean and Q max, so this is fixed. In that situation we will consider this PV bus after calculating these things, we will consider that PV bus is now can be treated as PQ bus, because here this PV bus is in this PV bus Q is fixed, and Q is fixed and P is already fixed, that means P and Q is fixed, and that means that is PQ bus. So after if the limit is violated, then in that situation we will consider the process of calculating the whole, that means that PV bus is considered as a PQ bus, and the calculation will be as accordingly. In this way the whole load flow analysis can be calculated, and from that calculated values of all the node voltage as well as Q reactive powers and delta also. So after calculating this, we will consider the line flows from the particular line, and hence we can easily calculate the loss of the system. Whole these things, that means the load flow analysis, is very very tough or very pathetic to calculate the system parameters, that means the unknown things, by manual process. In this way we cannot calculate the whole things manually for a larger system. That's why we need MATLAB or any program, that means digital computers, to calculate the whole system, that means the unknown parameters for calculating the system power loss. These steps, these are very tough to understand whole things in this way. It will be easy after, if we consider an example to solve the, to understand the whole steps of the Gauss-Seidel method. In the next lecture we will try to solve the example that is based on Gauss-Seidel method. Thank you all.